Oh my god.
That is my state right now. I'm smiling and I'm happy and I'm happy to see you all. So this is Facebook and Instagram live happening together. So hi to you and hi to you.
Hello. What a day to be here. Let's get cracking with the questions.
Yes.
So what's your trick to get the perfect Instagram click?
Perfect Instagram click. Firstly, it has to be top angle. I think it's just you look the best when it's slightly top angle. And if a smile works for you, if you've got a good smile, smile. Otherwise, you can make faces which people might not be able to recognize, so it's okay. So you can go to a pout, or I like a pout and a wing together. Like I like.
Okay. So Luka, Chuppi is getting massive praise all over. How does that make you feel?
Makes me feel like this. I'm very, very happy and I'm thrilled and overwhelmed with the response that we've been getting. And it's amazing because, you know, I've also gone to like different theatres to see the audience reaction. And it's the kind of film that, you know, makes you laugh, makes you, you know, smile at the end of it. And I was very, very happy to see people really laughing. There were places where they were clapping and hooting and whistling. So it's a very, very good feeling. And when there's a good balance of critics and reviews and the praises that are coming in, along with the box office numbers, it's like Sone Pe Suhaga. So I'm very, very happy.
Okay, so now we saw that you played Luka Chuppi with the Paps. What was that like?
Luka Chuppi with Paps, I played many, many times. I think it's our favorite game. And it was a coincidence actually, because I think somehow, you know, I had a meeting at one place, then I went to the salon, then after that I went to just pick up, like, I was really hungry, so I had to pick up like something to eat. And it was funny because they were sort of following me everywhere. So, and in my head I was thinking, yeah, my kapde change kar deti hu, kyunki main same outfit mein char jagah pe spot hui hu. But yeah, it was fun.
And so what was your favorite scene from the film overall?
My favorite scene in Luka Chuppi. So there are lots of them. I mean, I like the scene where he proposes and I say, oh, bhai sahab, ye kya kar rahe ho? I think that whole scene has, you know, a lot of like confusion and, you know, she's in a way a little bit commitment phobic also because it's too soon. And I remember when we were shooting that scene, matlab, I keep turning. So every time I turn, Karthik used to come the other side. Then I used to turn while saying some dialogue, then he used to come to the other side. So it was funny. But one of my really, really favorite scenes, which I also feel was a very, very important scene for me as an actor in the film, is this emotional scene, which is the only emotional scene in the film because the film is more in the comedy genre. So that's the only emotional scene where Rashmi, who is the girl who says ke ek tika lagana hai aur malai to pehni hai, main ready hun, she suddenly realizes, you know, the importance and relevance of that tika and mala, and she's like, you know, I can't stay like this, and I can't fool your family members throughout my life, and we need to get married. So I feel, you know, there's so much inside her when, you know, they're pretending to get married that time and that whole drama and all the rituals are happening, which every girl dreams of, you know, when you want to get married, you dream of, you know, haat ka print lete hain, aarta hota hai, kalash hota hai. So all those rituals are happening in her life, but she's not married. So all that is like sinking in, and it just comes out in that one scene. And Lakshman sir had kept it as a single take. So there are no cuts in that. So again, it was very important for me because it also grounded Rashmi as a character. So that is one of my favorite scenes in the film.
Okay, so the film had a lot of groovy numbers. Which is your favorite one out of the lot?
If I have to dance, then definitely Coca-Cola. I think... I love Poster like Bado also, but Coca-Cola is like, it just makes me groove every time I hear it. Then I also love Photo. I think Photo is one song which I can hear on repeat. And Dunya is again one track which is like that long drive wala track where you know, you're just on a long drive and you can play that on loop and it can go on and on and on, and it's like a soothing, nice, romantic track.
So, there's a video that's going around of you selling tickets of Luka Chuppi at the theatres. What happened about that?
It was really funny because, you know, I had actually gone to the theatre to see the reactions of the Janta, and I was crossing the box office counter where I was just a little curious to sort of see how many seats are blocked and how's the film doing and all of that. So I went on the other side of the box and I was seeing that where suddenly I was like, you know what, let me just sell it. I've bought my own film tickets many, many times, but this is my only mock of selling my own film's ticket. So there was someone who was asking for a Luka Chuppi ticket and it was so much fun to sell it. Ye maine kabhi nahi kiya tha.
So describe your five current emotions using five hashtags.
Five hashtags? Hashtag super excited, hashtag cloud nine, hashtag overwhelmed, hashtag gratitude, hashtag love you.
So if there's one thing that you want to say to all your fans right now, what would that be?
I think I would just want to say a big, big, big thank you to all my fans. I feel really overwhelmed. You know, it's been 5 years for me in the industry and the amount of love that I've been getting is more than what I ever expected. And the amount of love that they've given to my characters, whether it's from a Dimpi in Hirupanti to a Bitti in Bareli Ki Barfi, and now Rashmi, I just feel like they make me want to really, really work hard. And the 18 million love that I've been getting on Instagram, which is amazing. And I sometimes start questioning that, do I deserve so much? So thank you so much for always supporting me. I've been reading all the tweets. I've been retweeting, and I'm sure a lot of people might get irritated with my feeds these days, especially on Twitter and Insta, because there are too many, but I'm just excited.
What does the number 18 mean to you?
18. So 18 is adulthood, and 18 makes you feel like, okay, I know it a little bit more now, and now I'm a little mature, and now I can take my decisions, maybe now I'm there. So I feel like 18 on Instagram is sort of adulthood of Instagram, and also makes me feel like now maybe I'm there, and you know, with you all giving me so much love, 18 million people giving you love, that's a lot.
How does it make you feel that you have the ability to influence 18 million people right now?
It makes me feel great, but at the same time it makes me feel like I know that I have to be very, very responsible, because that's a lot of people. And I know that whatever I say, whatever I do, however I'm seen, is all something that people can pick up, people can get influenced. It can change their decisions or, you know, or inspire them. So I think I want to make the most of it. I mean, I usually try making the most of it. I usually also, like, I myself am the kind of person who likes reading motivational quotes or likes reading something inspirational. So there are many times when I might just post a picture with something slightly philosophical written underneath, and that the aim is it to sort of try and inspire you, and the aim is to sort of maybe try and make you happy if you're going through a bad day. I think you know, motivation quotes like really make me happy. When I'm going through a bad day and I read something really nice, it makes me feel good. So yeah, it's a huge responsibility, but it's also nice because it's me interacting with 18 million people.
That's awesome. It was good catching up with you and chatting with you.
Thank you so much. And